Loading 2D SEGY data is very similar to loading 3D SEGY data, with a few notable differences. To load 2D SEGY, first open the DocInsight launcher. Click Open Project to open an existing project directory. Select SEGY Loader as the application you want to launch. The SEGY Loader does not require much memory. The default 200 MB is recommended. Click Launch to run the SEGY Loader. The SEGY Loader is a wizard-based tool that leads you through the process of importing SEGY formatted data into Insight. I will load a 2D volume in time as post-stack traces. I add my SEGY files. I can select multiple 2D lines as long as they are all of the same data type. The survey line name can be automatically extracted from the EBCDIC header or taken from the file name. You can also manually type the line name if necessary. SEGY data is made of various headers and trace data values. Insight will use SEGY standard values as default settings and allow you to override these values if necessary. Checking the headers allows you to confirm that the values are correct. The EBCDIC header typically contains information such as the client, survey company, parameters, and processing used. It can also contain coordinate and CRS information. The binary contains sample interval, samples per trace, and the data format. The trace header contains the CMP shot point relationship, XY, XY scalars, and the start time. Insight will determine the most likely byte locations of the key information and highlight the values in bold font. By changing the number of traces, you can see the range of values at the listed byte locations. Looking at the EBCDIC header, it suggests that CMP is stored in byte 21, which matches the trace headers. The EBCDIC also suggests that X and Ys are stored in byte locations 181 and 185, which is again confirmed in the trace header. The XYs are also stored in bytes 73 and 77. Misleading information in the EBCDIC headers and non-standard mappings are common with SEGY data. If the trace header values do not match your knowledge of the data, try looking at the standard locations. If this does not help, display all the byte locations. The shot point does not need to be specified and is optional. In this file, the shot point is stored in byte 17. Finally, you can view the traces to make sure the selected sample looks okay. You can choose to import the survey geometry as a separate file later, or have it extracted from the SEGY headers. The default CMP and XY locations are correct. All I need to do is add the shot point. To create a decimal precision using an integer value storage, a coordinate scalar may have been applied, which can be specified here. If there is a difference in CRS between the SEGY file and the project, the coordinates will be converted during import. I can optionally filter data to exclude ranges of values based on CMP, shot point, X and Ys, and so on. Analyze the data to detect any problems and the extensive survey to be loaded. Blue text means no errors. Loading navigational files is optional when you have separate navigational data and you don't trust the values stored in the SEGY headers. I need to save the computed survey by giving it a name. Simplifying the survey will decimate the navigation, providing a huge increase in performance. To output the data, I need to provide a name to identify the volume. The data is stored as a .io file. I select a class to determine the default display properties of the data. Use the Advanced tab to change the output file bit depth 8, 16 or 32-bit. Once the writing process is completed, click Finish to exit the SEGY loader. If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.dug.com. And remember, have fun with Insight!